Look, if you stuck me in the desert with no water or gasoline for my sweet flamethrower motorcycle, I'd be pretty angry too. But is a Mad Max-esque fuel shortage ever gonna happen? First, let's set the stage a bit. In the Mad Max universe, gasoline is more than just fuel. It's a precious resource. It is the commodity. Lawlessness and a Borderlands-style dystopian future spring from a serious fuel shortage. Anyone is likely to kill you for a liter of the stuff. Hopefully we won't realize this future through a gigantic war like the Mad Max universe does, but the more likely fuel shortage scenario is something you've probably heard about before, so-called peak oil. Wait, but haven't we been hearing about peak oil for decades? Yeah, and that's part of the problem with this idea. What came to be known as peak oil was originally Hubbert peak theory, named after American geophysicist M. King Hubbert. Hubbert peak theory says that for any oil-producing region on the planet, the rate of oil production from that region will follow a normal bell curve. That is to say, when a source of oil is first discovered, production ramps up until it reaches some maximum value and then finally decreases as the oil reserves in that area are depleted. In a paper published in 1956, Hubbert calculated that US peak crude oil production would occur sometime in the 1970s, and this became peak oil. In fact, people in that decade were so worried by peak oil that they were lining up around the block, storing gasoline and fearing the worst. Since Hubbert's prediction, US oil production has actually recently increased. Since Hubbert's initial assessment, we've become much better at locating underground oil deposits locked away and squeezing more oil out of them. For example, we now have much better drilling technology able to go deeper to locate oil underneath the ground than ever before, and now we can also go horizontally with our drilling to get at hard-to-reach oil deposits. And with this directional drilling, we can now use hydraulic fracturing, or fracking, to pump water into these deposits, fracturing the rock and unlocking more oil. Finally, we are developing better and better imaging techniques to find more and more deposits, and we are also now drilling offshore for our oil. All of this innovation has actually led to an increase in US oil production. In 2008, we were producing 5 million barrels of oil per day. And in 2014, we are producing 8 million barrels of oil per day. In short, it doesn't look like we'll be fighting in thunderdomes over fuel anytime soon. Instead, we'll probably be doing more with less or something else altogether. If there is a limit on our fuel, it's probably an economic one. We're gonna be extracting similar amounts of oil and natural gas from the ground for a long time, but keeping those production rates high will become increasingly more expensive. This economic pressure will probably force us into alternative sources of energy, or at least cleaner ones, long before the actual exhaustion of oil ever becomes a problem. But if a Mad Max future ever really comes to pass and you really want to conserve gasoline, I have a tip for you. Stop making everything also a flamethrower. Why? Because science.
Oh, what a lovely day!
Want more science? Check out my last video on the science of Game of Thrones. Subscribe to Nerdist for more videos. If you want Because Science 2 days earlier than anyone else, head to Vessel at vessel.com/nerdist. And as always, if you have any comments or questions, hit me up in the comment section below. Thanks.